Early morning, Tisha B'Av, 1982. And I got up and I went to get dressed to go to shul, and I had an accident. So what happened was, in my closet there was a step stool and there was a carpet sweeper. Now what was that doing in my closet? They were never there before, I have no idea. However, at that time, our house was being worked on. We were having some construction of plumbing repiping. And the plumbing came up from the basement through the first floor, through the second floor, into the attic to go to the bathrooms. And I decided to take a look and see what work was being done. And so I stepped on this rickety step stool, and I slipped. I stepped on to look up, and I slipped. And when I slipped, the handle of the carpet sweeper went into my right eye. And it was awful, awful experience, an excruciating pain, and apparently I gave out an excruciating cry that my wife could describe better. And before I knew it, I thought I had really, really injured my right eye to the point where it may have lost vision from it. So what we did was we had a friend in Long Beach, his name was an ophthalmologist, Dr. Goldstein, and he examined me and he said, well, I got good news that it seems like your globe, that's the eyeball, was intact, but it's up in your head, turned up. And you injured the lower bottom of the eye muscle that controls the eyeball moving. He says, so I need to send you to the expert, a world-renowned expert in eye muscles, happens to be at USC here in Los Angeles, Dr. Stephen Felden, and he has to examine you. We'll get to him to examine you. So he gets on the phone and he calls Doheny Eye Clinic, and normally it takes months to get an appointment there. So he says, no, this is an emergency. Dr. Felden has to examine Dr. Lovitch today. Okay, send him down. And they took some tests and this and that, and he says, I want you to wear a patch. You have to wear a patch over your eye so you can only see from one eye. And then you come back in a month and we'll check you again and we'll see if there's any improvement or what we have to do then. Then I became very concerned and worried. Come back in a month, what am I supposed to do? I'm a surgeon, a young surgeon, young in my practice and young in my career, and I only have one eye. And surgery cannot be done with one eye. You have to have two eyes. You have to be able to have stereoscopic vision in order to operate. So I closed down my office, or at least the people who work there, I told them I'm not coming in. Maybe I'll come in to do some paperwork, but they can't schedule any cases for me. And sure enough, a month went by, and we went back to see Dr. Felden, and there was no improvement. So he said, you know what? I think that we've given it enough time. I think we need to do an operation on your eye so I can look and see if there's anything I can fix there. When the operation was over, he came out to the recovery room, and my wife was there, and he said to us, I have good news and bad news. Oh, what's the good news? He said, the good news is that we operate on you, and we found out that the eye muscle was intact, that it was injured severely, but not torn off the eyeball. The bad news is I couldn't do anything to fix it. Couldn't fix it. It's not fixable. It's just an injury that has to, it is what it is. So he says, you continue wearing the patch and then come to my office and we're going to get you special glasses, which are called prism glasses that divert the light. So because the eyeball was up in the head, whatever, change the direction of light and you can see. Well, I went home and I said, this is outrageous. Because a young man like me who was just starting out in practice, who spent his whole life preparing to be a surgeon, and what have you, to be now shut off. It seemed that I was shut off completely. So I called myself and I called Rabbi Groner. And I told him, I asked him, you know, this is, I don't understand this. We learned that everything is supposed to be for the good. Where's the good? I don't see it. So he talks to me for at length. I remember it was at least 45 minutes. Torah thoughts and Torah from the Pasha, and I even was taking notes as he was talking. And he said, you know what? I'm going to go and talk to the Rebbe. I'll get back to you. The next weekend, think it was a Sunday, we had a simcha in the community, and we come back early evening, and the phone rings, and the phone is Rabbi Groner. And he says, I spoke to the Rebbe, and the Rebbe asked me to ask you a question. Okay, what's the question? The question the Rebbe asked is, do you make Havdalah and Kiddush on red wine? So I said, sometimes, not always, sometimes white wine, sometimes grape juice, whatever we have. Uh-huh, he says, well, the Rebbe told me to instruct you that from now on you must make Kiddush and Havdalah on red wine. I said, okay, is that it? I didn't realize when the Rebbe gives you a hurrah like that, a teaching like that, you don't question it or even ask about it. So I said, okay, fine. And he said, okay, you keep in touch. Okay, fine. Next, so everybody in the community had heard about it. So next Shabbos, we had a Kiddush in shul. Everybody made sure that I made Kiddush for the whole community, red wine. And I will parenthetically say that from that day until now, there's always been red wine in the shul. Whatever the event is, whatever the occurrence is, they always have a bottle of red wine for me. Now, that was fine, and then the following week goes by, and we make Kiddush and Havdalah, and that's 2 weeks now. Now it's 6 weeks since the injury, approximately 6 weeks, maybe seven. And all of a sudden, the next morning, I get up, and there's a clicking, like in my eyeball, like it moved. I hadn't done that the whole time. And so, I said, Sharon, I said, there's something going on here. I don't know what it is, but there's something different. Okay, and it happened again and again. And by Friday, my eyeball was still up, but it was sort of, there was definitely movement. Kiddush and Havdalah, okay. And the next week, Kiddush and Havdalah. And then after that, the eyeball came down and has been perfect ever since. So I could see again without all these, without a patch, without prism lenses. I call Dr. Felden, and I said to him, Dr. Felden, you know, I have to tell you something. You know, this my eyeball is better. My eye, I can see again. He said, that's impossible. I said, well, I'm only telling you, I'm a physician. I can tell when I can see. So he says, okay, I want you to come down, and we're going to examine you again. My whole crew and the fellows at USC who are involved in this, and we eye muscle surgery, and we did go that day, or whenever he gave us the appointment, and he did look at it, and he said, you're right. Oh, thank you. It's fine. It's miraculous. It's almost, it's unheard of. So he then says to me, whom do you know? Whom do you know that you can get such a miracle happen to you? So I said, well, I had contact with the Lubavitcher Rebbe in New York City, in Brooklyn, New York. He said, well, whatever happened, it's miraculous and you're fine now. And I was very impressed that this rabbi, a Jewish rabbi, this doctor, a Jewish doctor, would acknowledge the fact that there was something beyond just his ability to repair it. It impressed me very greatly, and I've carried that with me my whole life and in my whole career, that there are things that happen that do not follow the normal course of Teva, of nature, and that there are definitely spiritual effects that can affect an outcome.